So we are here with Professor Robert Wesley, who is at Tulane University. Sir Robert, critical race theory, like when did that happen to you? What's that about?
Well, I mean, I've been exposed to critical race theory since I was in law school.
Okay.
Angela Harris was one of my mentors.
Okay.
It was started really early.
So how did it change going through law school, or did it change your life after law school?
Oh, it's changed. The movement, the discourse of critical race theory has changed tremendously over time. And lots of ways, including critical race feminism, Latino critical studies, and Asian critical studies. So it's reached out to include a lot more people and a lot more issues than when I was in law school, but it's only gotten better.
So what about Patrick? How did you first get involved with it? When did that happen?
Well, I got involved again with Black Group from, I guess I was
from the get-go.
From the get-go, I was on the ground level. This was something that people who were dissatisfied with the exclusiveness, let's say, of the critical race theory workshops and wanted to remain broadly to community issues addressed, got together and began with Black Crip conferences, and they've been going on now for over 12 years.
So when we think of Black Crip, we think of hearing, we think of the collective movement, we think of the conference, we think of the community. So what is it? What is it for you?
Well, it's all of those things. It's all of those things. I mean, everybody has their favorite project within the Black Crip portfolio. I've been heavily involved with the Critical Classroom. I've been on the CGC Critical Race Classroom project team now for several years.
How did that idea emerge initially?
Well, I think that they wanted to provide some study abroad opportunities for progressive students. And so the idea of partnering with law schools to provide those summer abroad opportunities that focus on social justice issues seemed unnatural for people involved in my career.
Let's talk to the community, the personal stuff. Often when one talks of a lab grid, it's like, you know, others do projects too, and others do conferences too, but that doesn't happen. It's the community. What does that mean, or what does that mean to you?
You know, the idea of Black Crip as a safe space where people who maybe feel alienated within the legal academy, within their homeschool environment, can come together and form real friendships, real human relationships with one another, and be supportive in things that otherwise they would not receive support. I think that's meant a lot to me, and I'm sure it's meant a lot to most people who have become involved with Black Crip. And it shows in the way that people remain involved year after year in Black Crip activities.
You use the expression safe space. Could you say something in any concrete terms? In what sense is it a safe space for you?
Well, it's a safe space in particular. You can talk about issues of sexuality. there. I mean, Black Crit has never been seen as so narrow that it only focuses on issues affecting the Latino and Latino community. It really is an open environment, but committed to a critical engagement of multiple categories of difference. And so issues of sexuality, issues of class, issues of race, issues of gender, and all of these things which are hot button issues within our societies, you can come to Black Crit and you can talk about these things openly and critically and find that there are other people that you really make a connection with, that who understand your perspective and who support your perspective. So, you know, it's not safe space in the sense that no one gets criticized, but it's a safe space in that there's no topic that's taboo.
Right. Where do you see the project 5 years, 10 years down the road?
Oh, I don't know. That's
David, what way would you like to see it?
Where would I like to see it? I would like to see it, Black Crit have, I would like to see Black Crit raise enough money to be able to afford to invest in a retreat center, a place where we can go individually and collectively to write, to read, to recuperate, and to enjoy being a member of the Black Crit family. So I think that would be a really important next step in the evolution of Black Crit as a community, as it has its own retreat center.
Well, let's try to get that done.